An announcement from the great and powerful Oz.
I didn't want Luffy in South Carolina. He did the whole shit on the Gullah people, which is the form of voodoo in America. Now, the CDC announced, in reality, that there may be some zombies coming back. This book here called Zombies, A Field Guide to the Walking Dead by Bob Curran. And most of those people born without minds are called automatons. The name of Dan Barlow and Ada Wadlow is called Love Zombie and Dan Barlow. And the CDC literally say, this is the notice, this ain't no sci-fi. They know what's going on. They're going to get a reprogram in their melanin. It's the automatons from the great Dan Barlow. And it's in their melanin. And they're going to get downloaded gods, immortals.
There is some sort of energetic download, a genetic trigger that goes off in your body where now you're able to remember things that you didn't know before.
Why so serious? Why so serious? Why so serious?
Of order out of chaos. And this has to do with the destruction and rebirth of Shiva, the destruction and rebirth of the Bennu, which is the Lord of Jubilees, which is the ritual that they started in December, which ends in November. It is the rebirth. It's the ashes and the rebirth of Osiris, which he is Horus as the resurrected Osiris. That's the black star. That's the star that David Bowie was singing about. And so we have all this ritual stuff going on. And not only that, we have Lady Gaga in her video actually shows a unicorn coming out of her. She is birthing a unicorn in this video, and it shows it coming out of the capstone. So this is actually a ritual that she's doing, and we know that Lady Gaga, her name means Pluto, which was the son of Saturn. Pluto is Hades. When Osiris died, he was killed by Set. He went into Hades as Pluto. The Bennu bird was the Ba, soul of the god Osiris. Some spells in the Book of the Dead aim to assist the deceased to transform themselves into Bennu birds so that they can travel freely between worlds. So we're talking about a parallel world and a Bennu, which we know that Hermes and Thoth, Enlil, he was the one who transferred the souls of the dead from one world to another. As far as the occult world goes, I mean, this isn't transferring them to heaven. These are gods of the dead.
Right, it's the gods of the dead with the Ogdoad again, Anubis, Hermes, and Pan, always guarding the gateways to the underworld. We're looking at this doorway portal opening, and what Chris and I have talked about previously is the use of CERN as a open sesame machine, an alchemy machine, a musical instrument that works off frequencies to open doors. And this is one of those interesting topics that I've always enjoyed that takes us back to Pan and the flute and Mozart and the magical flute. Takes us back to any of the old cartoons that you can remember where they play a sequence of keys on an organ and the sliding bookcase opens up. It's always about opening gateways, opening doorways, which is what this Jubilee seems to be related around with CERN and the opening of the doorway and the rolling out of the beast system.
The phoenix is associated with the Hindu god Vishnu. We know that Vishnu is also Jupiter, and he's connected to Imhotep, which is the mother of Ham's wife. Ham was the first phoenix. They actually started the Jubilee as a conception of when the Christ was put into the womb. Well, we know that their Christ is not our Christ. Right. It is just symbolic to them of when they are wanting their Antichrist to be birthed. The phoenix is associated with the Hindu god Vishnu. We know that Vishnu is also Jupiter, and he's connected to Imhotep, which is the mother of Ham's wife. Ham was the first that did the stretching of the cord ceremony, which is the Jubilees. And we know that the Jubilees has to do with the rising of the star Sirius.
Yeah. And I think Canaan was the one that was cursed. It was the son of Ham, right?
Right. The Benben stone is actually named after the mound that was a sacred stone. This is in the Temple of Ra, which is Saturn, in Heliopolis. Was the location the first rays of the sun fell, according to the Egyptians. It is the prototype for later obelisks and capstones of the Great Pyramid. So all of the obelisks we see, like in Washington, in the Vatican, all the obelisks that we see around the world in Berkeley, California, these obelisks represent the Benben stone. It represents the stone in which the Bennu bird was standing on to bring the rays of the sun on the capstone of the pyramid to birth the Ogdoad. From Orion is where the gate opens. If CERN wants to open a gate, CERN is a musical instrument. It has glass plates with words on them, with beams going through them.
Yeah, when you think about it, it's like having a sheet of notes up there and shining light through it. It's quite a complicated frequency and form type of old magic being conducted by CERN. I remember that Malachi Martin, the Jesuit priest, he discussed about the enthronement of Lucifer in the Vatican around the time of the end of the Vatican II Council. It was in the late 60s, and Vatican II, I believe, was around 65. And here we are having the culmination of this 50-year ritual being performed with CERN as the musical instrument, basically bringing this Apollo character or Nimrod character back.
Right, because it actually is a resurrected ritual. Why the Pope wears the Dagon hat in reference to worship of Saturn in the priesthood that actually behind the scenes they are a huge occult of Saturn. It has to do with the rising of the Nile, the 7-year Shemitah, and Orion, where the gate is, represents Shiva too.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So Shiva represents seven, and in the old ancient calendars, you see Shiva doing her cosmic dance with the sun and the moon to open the gate of Orion during the rising of Sirius, the star. That's the black star that David Bowie is talking about that is representative of Saturn. Because we know Saturn fell, Samael fell, and after that, after the flood and the resurrected Osiris represents Jupiter as the sun then, the king of the gods in the cosmic sky. So this represents the Ogdoad. Now we are going to have the phoenix rise again. This is what the Pope is doing the ritual for, the Jubilee.
All the weeks have to go right now anyway. Everything that's not balanced out and will never benefit the earth and will not put back into the earth as a leave the earth anyway. Whether the system goes on or it collapses, it doesn't matter. That's still going on because that's the universal law and that's the universal principle. Everything is not going to put back and it's going to continue to be parasites have to leave the earth.
Aspect of something. So again, they understand that even through the mental depth and all of the despair of the original man, he's still the governing head. You know, it's still, it is what it is. And royalty actually means, from one dimension, it means that you're the only real or organic being. You know? Royal comes from the Latin real or real. So royalty also means that you are an organic being. Your body has sufficient biochemistry to maintain itself through all of the shifts of the earth and all the different things that go on. Everyone else is temporary. And so that's why you're the inheritor and the progenitor.